It's 12 o'clock on a Monday. I'm Blaze.
I'm Juliana. This is Zhao Yu.
What up?
And welcome to Rave Train. Woo-hoo! In news this week, the holidays are right around the corner, and apparently I got word that Santa Claus is a DJ.
That makes sense. That makes sense.
And all his reindeers, they help him produce. Apparently.
Are they like his b-boys and b-girls?
Yeah, he throws down hard. Apparently, in like the North Pole, they have these crazy holiday parties out there.
Is Mrs. Claus twerking though?
She's
gotten like a little EDM makeover.
Yeah.
I imagine Mrs. Claus looking like Batty Winkle.
You know,
but like the Christmas Batty Winkle. That's what I'm seeing now.
We gotta get Santa Claus at our party.
Next Rave Train, Santa Claus season 4.
Season 4.
And on this week's episode, we have some amazingly talented dancers, as well as special guest DJs, BAD ROYALE.
And now it's time for Zhao Yu's Pearl of Wisdom.
Hey, drugs might lead to nowhere, but at least it's a scenic route.
Zhao Yu, press play.
Now you think EDM is done, that this EDM thing is just a trend. To all of you, I only have one thing to say. I'm just getting started.
Hey guys, I'm here with Kevin and Bruce of BAD ROYALE. How are you guys?
Great, thanks for having us.
Excellent.
Thank you so much for being here. Normally, I'd ask what these guys are playing, but I feel like they need no introduction. BAD ROYALE, take it away.
Thank you.
Like race me a parter. First bunny scene cause me have the blaster. Shalala, 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 la la la. Climax me de me a get the avalanche. Bubble, bubble girl, bubble. Bubble girl, bubble, bubble, bubble. Fee me right out of trouble girl, bubble. Bubble girl, bubble. Bubble girl, bubble, bubble, bubble. Fee me right out of trouble.
Ooh, la la la.
Girl,
let
me
move like ooh, la la la.
Girl, let me move like.
Drop it. you have a baby feel very good.
Free!
Why anytime you whine and catch it, it's electric, pull it up and put it for repeat, girl. Me not touch a dollar in my pocket, cause nothing in this world ain't more than what you want.
Bye.
And that's our show for the week.
Tune in next time.
We'll catch you at the after party.
What up, guys? It's Johnny Blaze, and this is my rant. This is the Baddest show where we talk about controversial issues in the rave community. We can come together and have a conversation, maybe figure some things out, maybe fix some things, maybe not, who the hell knows, but we're gonna talk about it anyway. And today we are talking about security checks at raves. I mean, dude, I've gone to some festivals and I've straight up had a security guard grab my penis. That's right, folks, I said it. A security guard grabbed me. And not only did he grab me, but he like fondled me like he enjoyed it. I've also gone to music festivals and events where security simply kind of gives you a little shake, checks your pockets, and lets you in. Here is my opinion on this. I think that security should be checking for weapons, and they should be catching dumbass people and people who are drug dealing. But if people are trying to sneak in, you know, a dime bag of weed or a couple pills, whatever it is, let them do it because it's gonna happen anyway. And all you're, by literally violating people, you're doing nothing but making the situation worse. There are some security guards and some security companies that I feel like are headhunting ravers and making this a huge issue for them. And then they're getting busted, which is making money for the police task force. I'm not sure of all these details. I could be making all this up in my mind, but this is what I feel like is happening. Maybe there's some connection between the police forces and the security forces, and they're like, hey, let's shake down these fucking kids as hard as we can and bust as many as we can for these small violations and rack up 60 G's per festival. Maybe some judge or something like that is getting paid off to deal with these, you know, kids. I've even heard stories of people going to the amnesty boxes and trying to put their drugs in the amnesty box and getting arrested as they're doing that. I mean, it's just ridiculous. And any smart raver who knows what the hell they're doing is gonna sneak shit in anyway. So security guards should be doing what security guards should do, making sure that everyone's safe. That's my opinion on this. I believe the promotion companies are hiring the security companies. The promotion companies need to be talking to the security companies that they're hiring and saying, you know what, I don't care if this is CSC or whatever, SCS or whatever the hell security company does it. We want good people. We're gonna treat our patrons with respect. So that's my rant. Hit me up. Have you had a bad story or a bad experience with security at a festival? I want to know your thoughts. If you've had good experiences, there's plenty of good security people out there. Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat. Get at me somehow. I want to hear your thoughts, people. Cheers. See you next week.
Let's rock this party.